About what my brother Honorable Seungu is saying, right, Honorable Speaker, it is true that teachers' training colleges were closed. And we've been having discussions with the stakeholders to convert them into what the stakeholders want. Right, Honorable Speaker, this afternoon I'm presenting the National Teachers' Bill for Parliament, to Parliament. And when you read through this bill, many of the issues that are being raised now are going to be addressed. I just want to pray that my brother, say Honorable Seungu, right, Honorable, it covers management of the entire profession, and which management also entails teachers. So I'm just asking you to be patient. By the end of this exercise,
Honorable colleagues, please. Please. Honorable Seungu, please, just let's wait. Now, the moment the minister says the issues you are raising are going to be handled in this bill which we have here, the bill is coming to your committee, okay? The bill is coming to your committee. I would say we be patient. And I don't want it to be an exchange between a member and the minister.
I will thank the minister for bringing the bill, however late it is, because you are almost 3 years back since you closed these colleges, all 2 years, 4 years, and it's a challenge on you. But still, you have to respond to teachers seeking for early retirement, because you don't have teachers to replace them, but they are going out, and at the end of the day, the effect is on our children. That is dodging it, and they have all the methods of stopping this early retirement, because the control is within them. They have the legal, they have the rules and laws governing it, but they are accepting it at a young age. So we want you to address that. You bring your bill, we shall process it, Mr. Speaker, as fast as possible, because it's a serious issue. But teachers running out for early retirement is a challenge on our schools. There are schools, Mr. Speaker, as we talk now, having one teacher per 100 children as a ratio. So, Honourable Minister, kindly give attention to that. And the
Thank you.
And Mr. Speaker, to be serious, I wanted him to note, as he goes back, you tell the senior man that Seungu is not joking here, but is talking sense. And
Thank you. Honorable Minister, you've taken note of that. But the issue of science aid teachers who are not being paid as scientists, how do we handle that, Honorable Minister?
Right, Honorable. First of all, I've taken note of the concerns raised by Honorable Seungu and others. Secondly, the issue of salary, science teachers getting more pay than the arts. Of course, you are aware that we took a policy to enhance.
Wait, it's different. The issue is science head teachers. Humanities, you find
yes.
A science teacher is earning more than a head teacher who is a scientist. Very simple. And the president gave directives on how it should be handled. The cabinet, the executive, we already agreed. Why don't you sort? Honourable Minister.
Right, Honourable, we got the directive and we are working with the Minister of Finance to make sure that this is collected. And I think the best person to give an answer to this is the Minister of Finance, not education.
You see, Honourable Minister, I think you need to go back, right, Honourable Prime Minister. Right, Honourable Prime Minister, I think you need to call a meeting, because now if you find a head teacher saying, if I fare back as a science teacher, as a blackboard teacher, I would earn better than my position of being a head teacher. And I'm a scientist, and he's saying I would rather go back to the chalkboard. Okay? So, right on, Prime Minister, why don't you call a meeting, public service, finance, education, and you agree on how to sort this?
Right, Honorable Speaker, I thank you so much. And I also want to thank God that you are here, together with all the colleagues who are traveling with you. You are still alive. Government is going to handle, and we shall come back here and give you that as
Right Honourable Prime Minister.
It is going to correct that mistake, government.
Right Honourable Prime Minister, can you give us a feedback on Tuesday next week? Don't you think it would be, do you think it's workable?
Right, Honorable, let it be Thursday.
This Thursday?
Next Thursday.
No.
Because if I talk about government, Right, Honorable, you are aware that we sit in cabinet on Monday.
Oh, on Monday. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, but cabinet is on Monday, so I wanted Tuesday. So let me give you Wednesday. Okay? Wednesday next week. Lope, you wanted to add on? She wanted to.
Thank you. I also want to join colleagues in thanking God for keeping you safe. I wanted to ask of government that as they bring that communication, I think it would be good that as the House and their country at large, we get to have an assessment of this policy. This policy was started to say, let's pay science teachers a lot more than the arts teachers with whom they sit in the same staff room, with whom they teach the same man hours, and so on and so forth. It would be good to have an assessment sometime down the road. Is there value for this which government was insisting on to say that the science teachers are way better than the arts teachers? Because it demoralized the arts teachers. They are being seen as non-entities. And yet they also contribute to this country. Many people in this institution are artists, lawyers, and so on and so forth. They are important to this country too. So it would be important that government helps us understand, if you are to put this policy on a weighing scale, how much have we gained out of it? Because rectifying just the element of paying the head teachers, let me just finish, Honorable Minister, saying that let's rectify and pay the head teachers who were science teachers originally much better. And that's why the arts teachers are saying, but this one was teaching sciences. Now as a head teacher, you're not even teaching. So they are asking, why should you be paid also as a science teacher? But they are saying, well, you said all science teachers should be paid better. We need to know, is there a value for this policy?
Thank you.
Otherwise, many of us actually from the word go saw it as a problematic policy, right, Honorable? All teachers should be paid well.
Thank you. Now, Honorable colleagues, I have an order paper to handle today. Please, I can see this is an issue which would... These are issues which the committee should be looking into, especially the point raised by Honorable Leader of Opposition. It's, you can't process it on the floor. Honorable colleagues, it's free sitting. I allow free sitting, so feel free.